Aaron, request this. Come on. Get on here. Everyone, this, okay, Corey and I went too long. It happens. And now we got to get Aaron in here. Corey, can you tell Aaron what to do? Okay. Go live with, come on, Aaron. Get in there. Isn't this fun? Okay, she's watching it. I can see that. Oh my God. This is like an old, like, I'm not even a millennial. This is how science, she says, try. Okay. Here we go. Go live with. Fuck. Okay. Oh my God. Okay. Well, let's see. Let's try it again. Aaron. Go live with Aaron. Aaron. I'm waiting for you.
Oh my God.
Okay. Hi. Okay.
I have to get someone to help me. Thank you, Brendan.
I'm so sorry, my love. I'm so sorry.
Okay. You look amazing. Okay. How are you doing?
I'm good.
I'm social distancing. Okay. I'm on a set right now. It's our first day. And we're social distancing and being good with masks. So I'm about as far away from everybody as I can get.
You're amazing. Thank you so much for doing this. Can we know what the project is, or should we?
Yes, it's called Grey Elephants.
Grey Elephants.
Here yesterday, yeah, and I'm started filming. This is the view from where we are, which is lovely.
Amazing.
We're in a house. It's all very exciting, all very strange with the COVID stuff. A lot of rules and regulations,
yeah,
obviously, to keep everybody safe.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's been great. I just flew in yesterday, so everything's a bit like, oh. But so good to see you, and great chat with Corey. Really important stuff.
Thanks. Yeah. And I mean, you know, I wish we could have done this all together, because to tell everybody, like, it's actually been you, me, and Corey, the three of us have been talking about this for the last year or so. And I'm so grateful that you're here to join in. And tell us what, just to recap, Corey and I were talking about how the three of us wanted to, like, you know, really inspire each other to a call to action, and to call each other and talk about what we're doing in the next month to make sure that, you know, we protect democracy and we get our voice heard and represented in our government. And it's a little special for you, I know, because you are a resident of America. You are,
yeah,
not, I don't know. I don't want to assume what your voting status is or can be.
I can't vote, maybe, unfortunately.
Okay.
But I can encourage others too, and I will be doing that.
I will say to you also, like, as you know, so many of our fans are not in America.
Yeah.
A lot of these wonderful, beautiful people are talking to us from all over the world, and I just want to say I love you all. Thank you so much. But maybe you can share with them, you know, why you're getting involved in this and what that means to you, what it means to be involved in an election in a different country, and why that's important.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're all aware of how important America's influence is in the world. But for me particularly, it's all around climate change. I've been listening to so many interesting and watching so many interesting documentaries and podcasts at the moment about how the mistruths spread about climate change are all down to, like, the oil industry. Obviously, this is all on record as well. It's like they have the emails from the CEOs in the oil industry, like, way back, like 90s, 80s, saying, you know, this is a moment where, when Thatcher was talking in the UK about climate change, and there was this shift towards a real understanding of how we are destroying our planet, and how at the time it was like greenhouse gases were the big thing, and now it's obviously more about CO2 and about fossil fuels burning, etc. It might all be the same thing. I'm not a scientist. But anyway, there was a shift, and everybody was understanding it. And then the oil companies got together with other big conglomerates and decided that they would spread mistruths, fake news about the fact that climate change wasn't being caused by our actions, and it is. You know, whatever. This is a hugely contentious area, but basically, I don't trust, why would you trust big companies? Like the tobacco industry told us for years that tobacco was fine and we wouldn't get cancer. And then lo and behold, it comes out that we get cancer. It just, for me, it's like I always think about who is benefiting from these things. So who benefits from us thinking that climate change isn't our problem? Companies. So obviously, probably, it's you know, in their benefit that we ignore climate change. Anyway, so America has a huge amount of that, and the president of America has a huge amount to do with that. So that's like why I think it's really important for us to, wherever you are in the world, to be focusing on this huge election and to be helping out in any way you can. And the way that I'm going to help is I'm going to be distributing information on my Instagram mostly, and also verbally, about voting and when the early voting is happening, where you can be voting in the different states, probably more focusing on the swing states, you know, just set there. And so the voting, the ballot, the postal vote ballot is incredibly confusing. My housemate has one, and I looked at it and I was like, how can anybody, you know, I feel like they make us make TV as if people are 14-year-olds, yet you get this ballot and it's the most complicated thing you've ever seen. So I am going to be talking and doing videos about how to fill in different ballots and, you know, how not to make mistakes, because there are a lot of voting ballots, the early postal voting ballots that were allowed 4 years ago because they weren't filled out correctly. So this is really, really important, obviously, that area. So that is what I'm going to be doing over the next week, Robin.
Fantastic. Yes, I love it. Brilliant. That is so great. And also, again, like, I think I speak for a lot of Americans. Thank you so much and for helping. And also, like, again, like you said, like, it's one fucking planet. Like, we're all connected. Like,
if COVID is sort of one thing, it is.
Yes, it's ultimately, unfortunately, yeah. It's a unified, I mean, it's we're all experiencing this together. And the breakdowns that we're seeing are what happens when we don't work together, unfortunately. You know,
exactly. The powers want to divide us, because as one global community of people, we are so much stronger than governments, and we're stronger than corporations. And once we're divided, we're not working in our personal best interest. So by coming together, you know, it doesn't matter who you are, as long, you know, we're breathing the same air, we're drinking the same water. It's insane that we can't drink tap water. We've taken that, like, oh sure, now we have to buy bottled water. Like, that is insane. Because our companies are polluted of water. I think we really need to come together. And, you know, there are lots of issues that divide us, but our air and our planet should be those, because we all have to live here.
Yeah. But I also want to say, too, I want to tell people, like what you're doing is so doable and fantastic. Oh, and everyone can do something like this. It doesn't have to be, you have to rewrite the Constitution. You know, it's like, it can be very small. Like, if all of us just do, you know, again, like I said with Corey, if the only thing you do is talk to a relative and ask them what their voting plan is.
Absolutely.
That, you know, that has an effect. Exactly. And thank you, because you show us that, like, that little thing that anyone can do affects people all over the world, regardless if they're American or not. So. Yeah.
And also, yeah. I phone banked for Hillary, and it was terrifying. The first phone call was terrifying, and then from then on, it was fine. So I know that it's a great, wonderful way to connect to people. And, you know, even if you're just having a chat with someone, like, how lovely right now to connect to people all over the world.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Totally. I mean, I just, yeah. And again, we did this with Corey, but yeah, let's give it a big shout out and a thank you to our beautiful fans out there. Oh my God. I miss you guys so much. but yeah, anyway. And so, yeah, I don't know. Let's touch base in a week or so, like on Tuesday. I want to ask everybody out there to come join us then, too. Maybe we can open up to a little bit more questions. You know, we have a lot of stuff to cover this week, but, you know, and then maybe, you know, we could have some extra other guests join us. Some special guests. People want to tune in for that. And and I'm just really excited to hear, you know, how your week goes, and I'll touch base with you too about what I'm doing over here. And And everyone, do that. Do it too. It's really fun. I love you. Break a leg.
Bye, everyone. Thank you.
Bye.